VOWR 800.
Hello, and welcome to Going Strong, the radio show that celebrates what we believe is the most vibrant culture in the world. My name is Deborah Collins, and each week I chat with guests who make a valuable and unique contribution to that culture and keep it going strong. This week I have the pleasure of chatting with two guests who have each made a significant contribution to the oldest radio station in the province, a cultural institution and a beloved mainstay of our community. What else could I be talking about but our very own VOWR, which this year marks its 100th year on the air. And my guests today are two longtime volunteers and on-air hosts at VOWR. Ron LeDrew, who has volunteered for 55 years and who also happens to be the manager here at the radio station. And Kay Donovan, one of our first female hosts and a favorite with her listeners for the past 15 years. Welcome to you both. Nice to have you behind the Going Strong microphones.
Thank you very much.
Well, thank you, Deborah.
It's an exciting time for sure here at VOWR, 100 years broadcasting through a whole host of microphones over the years. I've always said that things have longevity simply because they are good. They offer something of value, something people need and want and appreciate. So I'd like to throw a question at both of you. What is it that VOWR has offered people that accounts for its longevity and its success? Ron?
I tell you, right from the beginning, I guess, the Reverend Joyce, who started the radio station way back in 1924, he wanted to reach out to the parishioners of the church, those who couldn't attend church at the time, to be able to present the church service to those folks at home that actually couldn't make it to the church. And over the years, the station has grown into, I guess, a radio station that's offered a variety of easy listening music to the listeners. And I guess the listeners really enjoy that. I think we've reached out not only to the parishioners around the province, but to the many listeners.
Mm-hmm. How about you, Kay? What does VOWR offer that is unique in the radio world?
VOWR offers a personal service. Do people know we're going to be here? They know us by name, and we're here for a long time. Same people who come to volunteer stay here, so they know us. It's personal.
I always say they find a friend on the radio dial.
Yes, they think we're their friend, and we speak to them, and they know it.
And Ron, as you say, the voice of Wesley Radio, or VOWR, was the vision of Reverend Joyce, the minister at Wesley United Church right next door. Just over 100 years ago, radio itself was brand new, but he saw it could be used for something very special. And there are lots of anniversary celebrations planned for the months ahead, but the story of VOWR is now going to print. It was researched and written by longtime volunteer and on-air host Fred Greening. And we're giving listeners a sneak preview this winter as many of our volunteers share vignettes from that story on the radio. So let's have a listen to one of them as read by Kay Donovan.
There was no shortage of challenges for Reverend Joyce with his new broadcasting station. One was the obvious fact that a radio station needed listeners who had radios, and not many people had radios. In fact, few people could afford to buy them. Radio receivers were very expensive when broadcasting began in the early 1920s. Throughout Canada and the United States, people created crude, homemade devices, and they became known as crystal sets. Reverend Joyce showed his parishioners how to make them. They were constructed with some cheap, basic materials. They had no speakers. People had to listen through a headset, which meant only one person could listen at a time.
That is so interesting, a part of the story, Kay. When you read that, and when you're part of telling the story of VOWR, how does it feel for you to be part of this very special history?
I'm very, very, very excited about this 100th year. It's very, almost a loving feeling. It's part of a family when you're here in this station. And when you get here, I always joke and say, We stay here. We stay here as volunteers because we love it. The love of music brings us, and the love of VOWR makes us stay. It's a wonderful feeling to be here.
It sure is.
And at 100 years.
Yes, you know. And I remember, I've got to say, tell our listeners this, because it was a really funny moment at a volunteer event just before Christmas. And we were all sort of being given the opportunity to get our names and how long we were here and that sort of thing. And you were one of the first to speak, and you made some remark to the effect that we all love it here so much that we basically stay here till we die. And I remember thinking, well, as the rookie volunteer here, I just remember thinking at the time, I'm so glad I did my will. Because if that's the case, but I can see that, I can understand that, because there's a really special relationship that develops amongst ourselves as volunteers, but also with the folks that we speak to every day, every week, you know?
Yes, we're a family here, and we're a family there to them.
And when you sit behind the microphone, Kate, who are you talking to, and what are you offering them?
What I'm offering them is some lovely music, and we all bring our own music to these people, and they know who we are, and they know who they follow. They like one particular person over another, that's fine, because we all play our own kind of music. And I like to bring them something that they enjoy, that brings them back to a good time when they were skating, when they were dancing, when they had a certain boyfriend. I give them memories.
Because nothing brings back a memory like a song.
Absolutely.
And Ron, is that what makes VOWR unique? The fact that it is that special place where you feel like you have a friend. I mean, in a world where every second news headline can shock or dismay us, we all need a soft place to land. Is that VOWR?
Oh, definitely. And VOWR, you know, we often say we're all about the music here, and we are the music of your life. And certainly that's what we are, the music of everyone's life that's listening. And like Kay had mentioned, nothing better than a song to bring back, you know, a great memory. As far as the volunteers are concerned, we come here, it's like radio enters your blood. You're here to stay. Practically, very few people leave VOWR, unless maybe through illness or some other thing. But yeah, it gets in your blood. And we have 50 volunteers. And I tell you, that's what keeps the radio station going.
And as you say, I mean, we play the music that appeals to all ages. There truly is something for everyone who listens. It's also expanded a little bit over the years, and we'll talk about that in a few minutes. But first, let's hear some of that wonderful music that brings back memories. I've asked each of you to suggest a song, and Ron, you've asked for Vera Lynn's We'll Meet Again. Why that song?
Well, I tell you, here at the station, we think a lot about our veterans, and we think about all of the good the veterans have done for our country. A lot of our veterans from certainly the First World War and the Second World War are all passed on now, but there's still some veterans out there. And also the veterans from other parts of the world that the Canadians have been involved with, and so they're considered to be veterans as well. So we like to play music that goes back to that time, so that'll bring back maybe some not-so-pleasant memories, but also some nice memories from the wars in the past. So that's why, during my programs, I present a selection that for the veterans.
Can I add something to that?
Mm-hmm. Yes, for sure.
Every now and then, we get a phone call. Somebody says, I love that song you're playing, you know, and probably it's December, and I'll say, you know, we'll little chat. Well, maybe I'm away. Are you coming home for Christmas? Well, I can't. Where are you? Well, I can't say. And you know that it's probably one of our servicemen away who called just to make contact with home.
Well, let's hear the woman who brought so much positivity during the time of war, the one and only Vera Lynn singing We'll Meet Again.
We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again. Some sunny day. drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. We'll meet again. Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
That was the one and only Vera Lynn singing We'll Meet Again, a request of Ron LeDrew, the station manager here at VOWR. He's my guest today, along with Kay Donovan, longtime radio host here, who you can hear every Wednesday afternoon. You both know your listeners, and you both play music you know that your listeners love and appreciate. But of course, the music has changed over the past 100 years, you know. You'll still hear the gospel music that's been played right from the beginning, but a few other genres have been added. What can listeners hear in 2024, Kay?
Well, we all play our own kinds of music. My program is Music Unlimited, so my music is unlimited.
That's right. Yeah.
I play a little bit of semi-classical every now and then because I like it, and people like it. And that's why people follow us, because they like the kind of music that I play. We play all kinds of music. Everybody plays their own kind of music, and it covers everything. We go from rock and roll to semi-classical to
crooners?
Absolutely.
Yeah, traditional Newfoundland music?
Not so much in my program, because we have a 1-2 program
right.
of all that.
Who does that? Yes, of
yes,
course.
But
yeah.
We do have, you know, our Canadian content.
So something for everybody.
A little bit of something, yes.
Yeah. And Ron, there have always been a couple of interview shows over the years, too, featuring interesting people from the community. Barbara DeLand had a show for many years. Now Dr. Paul Gian has taken up that torch with guest interview. And now this one, Going Strong, the rookie show of VOWR. Do you see these shows as another way to connect with the culture and the community around us?
Well, yes, because we have some very interesting people being interviewed, and it goes back a number of years through guest interview, and it's gone through, I guess, different types of individuals, different occupations, whether they be doctors, lawyers, maybe they're artists, visual artists, you know, recording artists. So, yeah, we connect with the general public in that way. And our listeners get to know these individuals, where they may not have known anything about them before they're actually being interviewed. And a lot of, you know, good information that will come out of an interview that our listeners would certainly enjoy that.
Yeah, listeners hear the stories of the people mm-hmm. that they've only heard perhaps sing, or, you know, seen their paintings, you know, that sort of thing.
Yes, exactly.
Or seen in another professional capacity.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yes, yeah.
It's a personal look, you know, which again speaks to the personal nature of VOWR. And the audience is growing, isn't it? I mean, we still have a very loyal core audience in the 50-plus range, but I think the demographic is getting a little bit younger with both hosts and listeners.
Well, yeah, and, you know, I think we're getting younger listeners right now. We've always had the 50-plus age bracket for VOWR, but I think we're getting younger listeners now. I hear it, you know, talking to people. And these are younger folks that are enjoying some of this old music.
That's right.
There's nothing better than music coming out of the 50s and the 60s and 70s. Even on TV commercials, they're using these old songs. They can't find a new song to back up their commercials. They have to go to the old recordings. And so it's coming back big time.
Well, you can't keep good music down, can you?
No, for sure.
It'll find a way out. And Kay, it makes a difference, as you were saying earlier, in somebody's day, in somebody's life. You know, that whole notion of finding a friend on the radio dial. I've heard you say, now, you know, it's not a very nice day outside, but get a cup of tea, now put your feet up, and we're going to listen to some lovely music. You know, it's like spending time with a friend. You've chosen a song by Isla Grant, titled In the Time That You Gave Me. It speaks of doing the best we can in life with the time that we've been given. I can tell that that's important to you, and I think it finds its way in what you do here at VOWR.
When I do my program, halfway through, I like to acknowledge our special listeners out there. Those who are shut in, sick, lonely, sad. So if they're listening, I want them to know that I'm here and I know you're there, so I'm going to play a special song for you. And I like to play a song that has a message. So I'll probably say, listen to the words. And so I get calls after saying, oh, I love that song. Or I remember that song. All kinds of reasons why. I said to my husband, what is Kay going to play for us today? They want to know what that 3 o'clock song is because they know they take it. And I mean it. It's for them.
And one of those very special songs is In the Time That You Gave Me by Isla Grant. Let's have a listen.
In the time that you gave me, did I give all I could give? Did I love all I could love? Did I live all I could live? Was my faith in your grace strong enough to hold me? Did I do all I could do in the time that you gave me? In the time that you gave me, did I face the devil down? Did I make him turn away every time I stood my ground? If today is the day you should decide to take me, did I do all I could do in the time that you gave me? Oh, but I'll never know till it's over. But I want to fly on your shoulder. I might have strayed from the path, I might have gone a little crazy. I'd like to think I did you proud in the time that you gave me. Thank you. lie on your shoulders. I might have strayed from the path. I might have gone a little crazy. I'd like to think I did you proud in the time that you gave me. And as the hourglass empties, no, it won't even faze me. If I did all I could do in the time that you gave me.
And that was In the Time That You Gave Me by Isla Grant, a favorite of Kay Donovan, a familiar name and voice here at VOWR, and my guest today on Going Strong, along with station manager Ron LeDrew. Kay, when I listened to that song, I had the sense that your connection with the VOWR listeners is more than just a nice way to volunteer your time, though it really is. It's almost a calling. Is that what keeps you going strong?
My love for music keeps me going. If I can help somebody lift their spirits or bring back a memory, like I said, that's a good one. But I want them to know that I'm there. I know they're there. And I want to play something. I want them to get the idea of that song. So if they're sad and they hear somebody saying, well, do the best I can do, they might say, well, I can do that. Yeah. So if it helps somebody along, it's good.
You want to do your best in the time that you have here.
That's it. I do my best. And I hope they appreciate the music. I know they do, because we get so many calls. We can't always answer them, but we get a lot of calls.
Yeah.
And people feel connected to whoever's on the air.
You're touching people.
Yes, I hope so.
And Ron, you work with 50 or so volunteers here, volunteers like Kay. Is it that kind of attitude and approach that has kept VOWR going so strong for a century?
It certainly is. And you know, the volunteers, the on-air volunteers, they bring a lot of talent with them. And even though some of them may not think they do, but they do bring a lot of personal talent that goes out over the year, just their voices. And as Kay had mentioned, we get a lot of calls. We get a lot of phone messages here at the station. And, you know, one particular call stood out for me there just before Christmas. A lady had called up and said that her husband had terminal cancer and during the overnight had very difficult time in sleeping. And he would say to his wife that the VOWR is kind of keeping me going and helping me make it through the night and with the music. So it's pretty touching story there.
Doesn't get any more important, when it comes to reaching out to listeners. Is that what makes the story of VOWR so important to this place?
Well, for sure. I mean, over the years, there's been so many volunteers that I wouldn't be able to count the number of volunteers that have been associated with VOWR, but they bring their dedication with them, and they put their all into their programs. And like Kay had said, you know, they select their own music, and that's kind of a nice privilege for the on-air people to have, because now they're picking out selections that not only they like themselves, but they think that their listeners would enjoy as well.
And there's lots coming up over the next few months as we mark the 100th anniversary.
Yes, indeed. The 20th of July is the 100th anniversary, and we're going to be having a concert at Holy Heart of Mary on the 1st of June. We'll have more details coming out on that. We're hoping to have some great local artists coming together to celebrate for VOWR. We're going to have a banquet actually on the 20th, which is a Saturday, down at the Canadian Legion. And then there's a special church service here at Wesley in the following Sunday, which would be, I think, the 21st of July. So lots of things happening. In between that, we're going to be going out to some of the seniors' homes, and we have a small group of musicians, volunteer musicians here, that they'll spend a couple of hours with some of our seniors in some of the homes, and we hope to get out now at least once a month out to one of the seniors' homes.
And you obviously share the attitude of your volunteers, your fellow volunteers. You are a volunteer yourself. Now in your 56th year here at VOWR, Ron LeDrew, what keeps you going strong?
Well, I think for me, the radio was in my blood back when I was going to school, walking back and forth to Curtis Academy. And it was a pretty good walk. I had to go down to the East End. But I had a transistor radio with me. And I wasn't listening to VOWR, by the way. I was listening to either VOCM or CJON at the time. They were the ones that were playing the hits. VOWR weren't playing hits back in the 60s. They gradually came on in the late 60s, early 70s. We got into that type of music and into the country music as well. But it's in my blood. And I guess they'll have to probably carry me out of here. I don't know.
Well, I hope it's a very long time from now. But you've carved your own niche here at VOWR, too, and that's really important, and that's what everybody has done here.
And, you know, the volunteers that come here, like I said earlier, they want to stay. They don't want to leave. They like what they're doing, and they know they're providing a service. I think Reverend Mercer had said that we were kind of missionaries in our own way, and you know, because we're reaching out to the public like Reverend Joyce did back in 24. Since he reached out.
And like my mother used to say, onward and upward from here.
Yes, indeed.
Well, Ron LeDrew and Kay Donovan, thanks to you both for being here and sharing your thoughts on this radio station that we call our second home. It was a quick 30 minutes for sure, and that is going strong for this week. But fortunately for our listeners, VOWR is on the air 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Thanks to people like Kay and Ron and all the other wonderful hosts and volunteers who bring you some pretty great programming. My name is Deborah Collins, inviting you to join us again next Tuesday evening at 7:30 for Going Strong, right here on VOWR.